Hello.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Welcome to Myth Busting Mondays.
Yes, today we're talking about myths, because that's what we do every Monday. We bust a myth about love, dating, relationship, that kind of stuff. So today we're talking about this myth. Will someone change for you? Will that person change for you?
Right. The right person's just going to change for you, right? They're going to change what they believe. They're going to, if you just love them enough, right? You just give enough love and you're going to change their mind.
So we hear this all the time. Oh my gosh, he's perfect. Except,
well,
there's this thing, right?
Yeah.
It's like somebody isn't perfect, but, right? You can't love someone, but, right? There's always that weird but in there. So we're kind of addressing this idea that you're just going to, you know, that it'll change once you're married. Let us tell you it doesn't.
It doesn't. No.
It doesn't change once
you're
married.
You don't suddenly get a commitment and that person suddenly stops being the person that they've been, that you knew all along, and suddenly decides that they do want kids or they do like cleaning the house or whatever the thing is, right?
Scrubbing the toilet,
right? It's, you know, you're not going to get a commitment and then suddenly things are going to be different, right?
They're really not.
They're not. You know, you know, I went on this date years ago before Orna, not recently.
I hope so.
Right? And it was this woman, and she actually pursued me for the date. You know, she asked me out, and I was like, all right, sure. And we went out, we had a really nice time, we had some drinks, and it's before when I was, you know, before I was sober. And we ended up fooling around. And that next morning, me being, you know, the kind of guy I was, thinking, hey, I should be honest with her. I should be upfront about who I am and what I want. And I said to her, you know, I don't really see this going anywhere.
Uh-oh.
You know? And her response wasn't, wow, I'm really bummed about that because I like you, right? No, her response was, oh, you just wait and see. I'll show you. Well, needless to say, we didn't end up together because as much as she tried to show me, it just wasn't, I didn't feel it, right? I couldn't change how I felt about her because she wanted me to.
I mean, the reality is the right person for you, the ideal match for you, is how we like to say it. The ideal match isn't going to be somebody that you need to change some fundamental thing about them. You know, changing behavior is something you can request, but don't bet on it. You know, behaviors are habitual.
Right. They're hard to change.
They are. I mean, you know, I know we all have our little addictions, whether it's the phone or a video game or, you know, an actual, you know, detrimental addiction, like, you know, alcohol or drugs or whatever. But the thing is that our behavior is basically based on habit. And so asking someone to change who they are isn't really an acceptable option when it comes to deciding if this person is an ideal match or not. You can certainly make a request about something and then see how they respond. But if they're unable to deliver and it's something that's really important to you, or you're a mismatch when it comes to your values, right? You can't ask somebody to philosophically change who they are or how they view the world.
Right.
They're not going to see things the way you do, even though in the first phase of relationship, that yummy, humana romance phase, it seems like you're on the same page with everything.
Right, exactly.
In the very beginning.
Because you're having all those good feelings and you know, you kind of ignore the things that you don't really agree about because you're
that's
just having too
fun.
Much fun, right?
Yeah.
You want to have fun together. So why even think about the fact that this person in 5 years doesn't want to sell everything and move out to the country, right? Just because, you know, they're going to come around because they really like you and they'll see things your way. Just stick with it. They'll see things your way, right? It's not going to work.
The wink, right?
Right?
Like, no.
No, right?
It's
you're
not
just setting
work.
Yourself up for divorce.
Yeah, don't set yourself up for divorce.
No,
right?
It's a bad idea.
If you know you want to have kids and the person you're dating either is ambivalent, like not sure, and you're a grown-up, right? And you know you want to have kids, don't bet that they're going to change their mind down the road or you're going to love them enough or they're going to see, oh, I mean, I know for me, we're childless by choice, which, you know, was a choice to make. And I always think it's funny because nobody ever asks a couple to justify and reason out why they're choosing to have kids. And yet those of us couples, right, who choose not to have kids are asked over and over again, well, why not? As if, you know, anyway, the bottom line is, if somebody should know who they are, if you're thinking about spending your life with them, they should be grown up enough, an adult enough to know who they are.
Yeah.
So if they know who they are and they're sharing that with you, believe them.
Yeah.
Don't think you're going to suddenly change who that person is.
By the way, we had that conversation about children on our first date. Not, I don't recommend you sitting in and making your first date about, you know, well, these are the things that I want out of life.
That's
you
not
want
how them it to? Happens.
Right? That's not what we're saying. It just happened that way as part of the conversation. It was sort of organic about what was going on between us. But we did have that conversation early on, and we were both in agreement right away. There wasn't any, like, you know,
weirdness.
There wasn't any hidden agendas or anything going on. No. Weirdness. Right? So, you know, the truth is you can't make anyone do anything. And if you think you've met the right person, but right, then they're not the right person.
Then you've got to move on.
Don't try to fit that round peg into a square hole, right?
Yeah. Let that person deserves to be loved by somebody who sees eye to eye with them, that they have a philosophical values match about how to move through the world together. I think a lot of times we think somebody's going to change. Right. I was told when I was younger, I would change my mind. I would want to have kids. And the thing is when people would see me with kids, particularly when my friends started to have kids, they were like, oh, you're going to want kids. I'm like, no, I like children. I just don't want to have my own. See, I will come and be Auntie O and I will watch your child. And then I will be happy to leave them with you so I can go home. Right. I knew that my time, it wasn't going to be something that I did, you know, this time around. I've teased Matthew that, you know, we can have him in our next life when we're, you know, and he's like, in our next life, we might both be men. And I was like, great. Then if we want, then we can adopt. Who knows? I mean, the reality is these are the conversations you want to have with somebody over time to discover if you're a values match, but don't tuck it away that there's a mismatch and that, oh, down the road, that person will change for you. That person's not going to change for you. Change is difficult. Change of behavior is difficult. Mm-hmm. But people only change when they want to. And even when they want to, they can find it really hard. I mean, if you know anybody who's ever quit smoking, I never smoked. I had a boss that smoked. I mean, we used to joke, like in the workspace, you know, we'd be like, do you get up at night to smoke? And he's like, sometimes, you know, he's like, sometimes I smoke when I'm in the shower. I was like, I don't even know how that works. Like, you know, wash your hair. I don't know.
I can't imagine.
So changing those kinds of things are possible when someone wants to change, but they're not probable if they really don't want to. Right? And most people don't want to change. What we want when it comes to love is we want somebody to just love us as we are, warts and all.
Yeah.
So when you find that person that's an ideal match, it's kind of like you found them at the as-is section at IKEA, right? It's like, there they are in the as-is section, and yeah, there's like a little blemish or a ding or a scratch or two, and you're like, oh, you know what? But I love this thing just as it is. I love it, and I'm going to take it home. And I know, I didn't mean to think of a person as a thing, right? But it's this thing where you have to be able to accept somebody for who they are, because that's what you want too.
Yeah.
You want somebody to look at you and say, wow, she's all that, or he's all that. I don't need them to change a thing.
And you gotta really be clear on the difference between behaviors and beliefs, right? When we first started going out, and if you followed us for a while, you probably heard this story, right? Orna made a request for me. She said, I would feel really cherished if you would open the car door for me. Now, I had never been a guy who opened the car door. I wasn't raised that way. It wasn't the environment I grew up in. And, you know, it could have been that I had a philosophical belief that, look, hey, you know, men and women are equal, honey. You can open your own damn door, right? What am I? Right?
Hey.
I'm not your valet.
Watch out.
Right? It could have been that.
Get back on,
right?
Jack.
And if it was that, then we probably wouldn't be here doing this video.
We wouldn't be sitting here today.
Because we wouldn't have been a values match. But the truth was, it was just something that, you know, I didn't normally do. But when I thought about it, and I thought about her, and she said, I'd feel really cherished if you would do this. And I thought, well, she's cute, you know, and if I do that, she's going to like me more. So, okay, right? So the thing is, it took me a while to get it right. It's not like I just the next day was like perfect at opening the car door. It because it's a new habit. I wasn't thinking about it. Most of the time you're going to the car, right? You're not thinking about, all right, I got to go open the car door. And Orna was really great about it. She just sort of stand there next to the door.
Mm-hmm. La, la, la,
la, la, la, la, la, right. And I'd get in the car and I'd go, oh, right, I got to go open the car door. And I get out and I go around and open her door and let her in. And then, even then, she was great about it. She'd just say, well, thank you. I really appreciate that, right? She didn't go, I can't believe it, and get my car door again. You know, so
I knew it wasn't a habit, yeah. Right? Then I knew he was working hard to
figure
it out.
So things like that can change, right?
Yeah.
That's the point. Things like that can change. If it's just a behavior, it's not a belief system, it's not something that's so important to you. But if it was important to me, then it's a different story.
Yeah. I mean, it sounds superficial to say we wouldn't be sitting here right now next to each other shooting this video for you if Matthew had a philosophical reason for not wanting to open my car door. But it would say a lot of things about him and about me that we weren't an ideal match. And instead, he said, oh, I could do that for you. And he made it a habit to the point of where he shows up valets, you know, all over Los Angeles, at least in the days when we used to go out.
Yes, the days when we went to places that had valets.
We don't go, we don't get to go out anymore. That's okay. I mean, look, whatever is important to you, you can certainly make the request and then see how that person responds to your request, right? And see if you're on the same page philosophically, ideologically, not just emotionally, sexually, chemistry, right? You want to check the other stuff too, because lasting partnership comes from accepting somebody warts and all.
That's what you want. Isn't that what we want, right? Yeah. Isn't that what we want? We want to be loved for who we really are. We want to be loved even when we're a little crunchy in the morning, like, you know, somebody was today. But it's okay, right? We want to be loved for that anyway. Now, the only way
I was a little cranky this morning.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah, see, he gave me all that, I'm going to love it out of you. You know, I mean, it was cute. And I was like, eh, whatever, I didn't want to hear it at the time. But we all have our good days and bad days, right? So let somebody be who they are. See them for who they are. Do not date backwards, giving somebody who is a stranger the benefit of the doubt.
Right.
You know who's earned the benefit of the doubt? Somebody you've been with for years. We tend to not give the benefit of the doubt after we've been with somebody for decades, and yet we pass out the benefit of the doubt to a stranger in the early part of that romance phase relationship. Don't do it backwards. Do it the other way around. Take off your rose-colored glasses for the dating process. Save it for when you've made that lifelong commitment, whatever that looks like for you. And once you're in it to win it, go find them in the drawer, dust them off, then put the rose-colored glasses on. See that person for who they really are. Acknowledge their best efforts. Let them have a bad day once in a while. Love them up anyway. And just know you're going to find your way through the little bumps and conflicts together. Life is always going to throw you curveballs. Don't expect up front that someone is going to change their belief system about what's important to them just because, wow, you're a great person and they want to be with you. That's just, it's setting yourself up for disappointment.
Yeah.
And we want to set you up for the win-win, where you create that soul-satisfying, long-lasting love that you desire and deserve.
That's right. So we're here every Monday busting myths about love that get in the way of creating that kind of long-lasting love. So if you have any myths you want us to bust, feel free to put them in the comments. And tomorrow,
Ask O&M Live.
That's right.
I'm O.
I'm M.
And tomorrow at 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern, we'll be taking your questions live right here in this group, Common Sense About Love. Remember, this is a private Facebook group. So when you see one of our posts or videos from this group in your timeline, that is not public. That's there for you, because you're part of the group. So only members of the group see the posts, comments, and videos in the group. So if you have a question about dating, mating, or relating, please post it either in the live feed tomorrow when we go live. You'll see the comment there, just like you see us now with the video, or we'll put up a post later tonight if you want to ask it in advance. We know a lot of people are around the globe. Hi, people around the globe. You might be asleep right now and catch us later. So if you want to ask your question in advance, we're going to look in those two places tomorrow for questions, either in the one we put up tonight or the live feed. We'll be answering your questions live.
All right. Have a great night.